Good morning, students. I welcome you all to my this channel, and I am going to continue with the same lesson number 2 from your book Niffa's Flight of English, and the name of the lesson is Nelson Mandela Long Walks to Freedom. Now children, this itself is written by Nelson Rolihlahla Mandela. How you will pronounce? Rolihlahla Mandela. So this is about the lesson. Now let me tell you, before beginning the lesson, I would like to discuss with you the important points of the lesson. That is, I already told you about the author, that he was a who gave freedom to the blacks in South Africa, Africa, and he was born in the village of Mawezo in Upmatata, which is a part of South Africa's Cape Province, and he fought against the apartheid regime of South America, which believed in only racism. And children, he spent more than 30 years in South America prison. He became the first black president of South Africa. When his parts came to power, when he came to power in the election of 1994, okay, then how he addressed the world, at least more than 140 dignitaries from different international countries were present during the opening inauguration ceremony. So it is a saga of the glorious struggle that the black of South America had against the apartheid region to gain freedom. Now, children, actually the theme of the lesson is that those black heroes and patriots who waged a relentless struggle against the apartheid or the racist regime of South America. Here we find a description of the imagination ceremony held in the Union Building, attended by politicians and dignitaries from more than 140 countries. Nelson Mandela gave a message. What message he gave? He gave the message of peace and unity of mankind. He foresees a new regime which will be based on the equality of men and women. He hopes that in the new regime there will be no exploitation of man by man. There will be no room for racism and segregation in the new order. Now children, then there is a summary also. Okay, some important points of the story is that the inauguration ceremony of the first non-racial government was held in the Union Building in Pretoria. Politicians and dignitaries from more than 140 countries attended the ceremony. Nelson Mandela was then sworn in as the President of the Republic of South Africa. For decades, South Africa had been the seat for white supremacy. The blacks were considered as outlaws. The victory over apartheid was a common victory for justice, peace, and freedom. Nelson Mandela was overwhelmed with a sense of history. The society based on racial discrimination was the harshest and most inhuman society in the world. The decades of oppressions and exploitation of the blacks produced heroes like Tambo, Sisulu, and others in South Africa. Mandela learned the meaning of courage from such brave comrades who were ready to sacrifice their life for the freedom of their people. Every man has twin obligations or responsibilities towards his family and for his people and country. If any black tried to live like a free human being, he was punished and isolated from his family and community. Mandela realized that not only he, but his brothers and sisters were deprived of freedom. His desire for the freedom and dignity of his people made him rebel. He realized that freedom is indivisible. So children, this is all. Now some important points we have already discussed earlier, like it was the first non-racial government. Mandela's speech became the world famous speech. Impressive displays of jet was there during the time of inauguration ceremony. Scenes of history was there. Okay. Then policy of apartheid was discussed. The struggle of comrade was also discussed by Nelson Mandela. Then twin responsibility were told by him. So joining the F, and finally how from a very shy boy, from the lover of freedom, okay, he became he joined the African National Congress. So this was all discussed, and even I have discussed this points for, okay. So Nelson Mandela, we already know, he has become South Africa's first black president after more than three centuries of white rule. So three centuries of white rule, where racism was at its height, he became the first black president, and he ruled the Mr. Mandela's African National Congress Party won 250 of the 400 seats in the first democratic election of South Africa's history. Now children, the inauguration ceremony took place in the Union Building Amphitheater in Pretoria. And what happened, this is discussed here, what happened during that time. The whole chapter is in the beginning, the whole thing is being discussed here. It was attended by politicians and dignitaries from more than 140 countries around the world. Never again with this beautiful land experience the oppression of one by another, said Nelson Mandela in his address. Jubilant scenes on the street of Pretoria, followed by the ceremony with blacks, whites and colored celebrating together. More than 100,000 South African men, women and children of all races sang and danced with joy. Okay, then children, so many things are to be discussed here in the chapter, but that we will be doing when we will, I will be doing the explanation of the lesson. Okay, so so this is the book, and first the open to page number. Yes, page number 16. So Nelson Mandela, I will be reading. Nelson Mandela, Long Walks to Freedom. It is written by Nelson Rolihlahla Mandela. So what is the pronunciation? Pronunciation is Nelson Rolihlahla Mandela. We will read right this. Rolihlahla Mandela. Before you read, there is certain point is there, apartheid. So what is something about apartheid has been told here, like apartheid, which is which means discrimination based on color and race. And in the book, what is written here? Apartheid is a political system that separates peoples according to their race. So it is a political system that separates people according to their race. Now, can you say which of the three countries named below had such a political system unit very recently? United States of America, South Africa, Australia. So children, we all know it is South Africa. Have you heard of Nelson Mandela? Mandela and his African National Congress spent a lifetime fighting against apartheid. Mandela had to spend 30 years in prison. So how many years he had spent in prison before becoming the first president? So he has spent 30 years in prison. So he has, children, 30 years in prison he was, which is a very long time, I think. Finally, democratic elections were held in South Africa in 1994, and Mandela became the first black president of a new nation. So he became the first black president of the new nation. So the election which took place in 1994, and Mandela became the first black president in 1994. Okay. Then children, Mandela becomes South Africa's first black president. Let's see what is written in this appetizer or in the box. Nelson Mandela has become South Africa's first black president after more than 3 centuries of white rule. Mr. Mandela's African National Congress, ANC, party won 250 of the 400 seats. So how many total seats were there? 400, and his party alone with 252. So quite a large seat he has won, and definitely he has to become now the president. In the first democratic election of South Africa's history, the inauguration ceremony took place in the Union Building Amphitheater in Pretoria. This you can underline, children, because this is a very important part of the lesson. So, where does the inauguration ceremony took place? In the Union Building Amphitheater in Pretoria. Okay, what is the amphitheater, children? A roofless building where the sitting arrangement is there, just like the Romans and the Greek used to do. Okay, like a stadium, a round building used to be there without roof, and seats were arranged in a circular style. Okay, so the inauguration ceremony took place in the Union Building Amphitheater in Pretoria today, attended by politicians and dignitaries for more than 140 countries around the world. Never again will this beautiful land experience the operation of one by another. So, never again will this beautiful land experience the operation of one by another, said Nelson Mandela in his address. Jubilant scene on the street of Pretoria followed the ceremony, with blacks, whites and colored celebrating together. Now children, black and white color, that means color were the brownish colored people, like we Indians are colored people. Okay, and blacks were the Africans, white were the Europeans and the Americans. More than 100,000 South African men, women and children of all races sang and danced with joy. So more than 100,000 South African men, women and children of all races sang and danced with joy. Okay, so now we are going to read the lesson. So this was in the appetizer. Okay, so 10th May dawned bright and clear. Dawn is presented in itself. Dawned means so children, it was 10th May 10th May dawned bright and clear. Dawn means presented itself, that day had presented itself in a very clear manner for the past few days. Okay, for the past few days, I had been pleasantly besieged. Besieged. Okay, let me write some of the new word meaning. Basis. What is the meaning of basis? Surrounded closely by. Okay, so it was 10th May. Dawned at me, it presented bright and clear. For the past few days, I had been pleasantly busy, surrounded by dignitaries and the world leaders. So now, children, everybody knew that he would become the president. He would become the president, and he was busy. He was surrounded by dignitaries and world leader who were coming to pay their respect before the inauguration. And children, these people, in fact, they were coming to pay respect before inauguration. The inauguration would be the largest gathering ever of international leaders on South African soil. So he is telling that the inauguration would be the largest gathering ever of international leaders on South African soil. So it would be one of the children, biggest gathering in the South African soil. The ceremonies took place in the lovely sandstone amphitheater. Now this again you have to underline it. So children, the amphitheater, the meaning of amphitheater is written in the gloss only. A building without a roof with many rows of seats rising in steps, typical of ancient Greece and Rome. So children, the ceremonies took place in the lovely sandstone. All the ceremonies, it used to place where? In the lovely sandstone amphitheater formed by the Union Building in Pretoria. For decades, this had been the seat of white supremacy. White supremacy. Okay. What is the meaning of white supremacy? The center of racial superiority. This is an important word, note it down. White supremacy, the central for, okay, so you can write the central of racial superiority. And now it was a site of rainbow gathering of different color. And today, children, you can see it was a, see how nicely the idioms has this line is, a rainbow gathering of different colors and nation. What is the meaning of this? It means a beautiful coming together of various people like the colors in a rainbow. Okay. So the ceremonies took place in the lovely sandstone amphitheater formed by the Union Building in Pretoria. For decades, this had been the seat of white supremacy, and now it was the site of rainbow gathering of different colors and nation for the installation of South Africa's first democratic non-racial government. Installation means putting in a new position of the authority. What is the meaning of installation? Putting in the new position of authority. On that lovely autumn day, I was accompanied by my daughter Zenani. So children, that was a very great day for everyone, and of course especially in the life of Nelson Mandela. Children, he was accompanied by his daughter Zenani. So what is the meaning of with whom he has accompanied there? He has accompanied there with his daughter Zenani. On the podium, Mr. D. Clark was first sworn in as second deputy president. Now children, first thing what happened on the podium, Mr. D. Clark, he was first sworn in as the second deputy president. Then came the turn of Thabo Mbeki. He was sworn in as the first deputy president. When it was my turn, I pledged to obey and uphold the constitution and to devote myself to the well-being of the republic and its people. Now the wonderful moment has come where Nelson Mandela was called. I pledged to obey and uphold the constitution and to devote myself to the well-being of the republic and its people. To the assembled guests and the watching world, I said. Now children, let's say about his speech, what he had spoken. Today, all of us do, by our presence here, confirm glory and hope to newborn liberty. Now children, wonderful speech he has given. And here confirm means give. So children, in his speech, let's see what he has spoken. Today all of us do, by our presence here, confirm glory and hope to newborn liberty. Out of the experience of an extraordinary human disaster that lasted too long must be born a society of which all humanity will be proud. So he is telling that today is the day where a newborn liberty is going to take born out of the experience of an extraordinary human disaster. Now children, he already had a experience of extraordinary human disaster that lasted too long. Must be born a society of which all humanity will be proud. We who were outlaws not so long ago have today been given the rare privilege to be host to the nations of the world. So children, outlaws here means bandits. So who children, once who were the outlaws, today outlaws means bandits. So those who were outlaws, they were given chance. They have been given a rare privilege to be host. Host are the innkeepers. They are the hosts, they are the innkeepers to the nations of the world on our own soil. We thank all of our distinguished international guests for having come to take possession with the people of our country of what is, after all, a common victory for justice. And he is telling that we thank all of our distinguished international guest. We all know that more than 140 top most dignitaries from all over the world came to pay homage, pay respect to the president. He is thanking all of our distinguished international guests for having come to take possession with the people of our country for what is, after all, a common victory for justice, for peace, for human dignity. Dignity is grace. Okay, so he is telling for peace, for justice, and for human dignity. We have at last achieved our political emancipation. Emancipation means freedom from restriction. Okay. We pledge ourselves to liberate. Liberate means to free. To free. We pledge ourselves to liberate all our people from the continuing bondage of poverty. Bondage is binding. Deprivation. Deprivation is not getting a thing. Suffering. Gender. and other descriptions. So far, finally, he had got freedom from all this. Okay, never, never and never again. Never, never and never again shall it be that this beautiful land will again experience the oppression of one by another. The sun shall never set on so glorious a human achievement. Let freedom reign. God bless Africa. So this was the speech which Nelson Mandela gave during the inauguration ceremony when he became the black president, first black president of African National Congress in 10th May. Now, student, I am going to discuss the question answer, which is given on page number 18 and 19. So, first question, where did the ceremonies take place? Can you name any public building in India that are made of sandstone? Of course, the inaugural ceremony took place in the lovely sandstone amphitheater formed by the Union Building in Pretoria. For decades, this had been the seat of white supremacy. In India, we have many buildings which are made of the sandstone. They are the Parliament, the Rashtrapati Bhavan, and the Red Fort in Delhi. Can you say how May 10th is an autumn day in South Africa? In South Africa, 10th of May was an autumn day. Literally as well as symbolically, in autumn trees, leaves old and rotten leaves, and after that new leaves with fresh color are born. Symbolically also, the old and rotten system of apartheid is now no more, which was coming to an end. A new republic based on equality of men, women, and without apartheid. You can see the equality of men, colors and races was taking birth on the 10th May during the autumn season. At the beginning of the speech, now children, at the beginning of the speech, Mandela mentioned an extraordinary human disaster. What does he mean by this? What is a glorious human achievement he speak of at the end? At the beginning of his speech, Mandela calls the apartheid regime based on racial discrimination as an extraordinary human disaster. The people were deprived of justice, peace and human dignity. Now the new republic ensured social justice, equality and human dignity. Never will South Africa see any exploitation of men by men and racial discrimination. What does Mandela thank the international leaders for? So students, Nelson Mandela thanks the international leaders for sharing a common cause. By participating in the ceremony, they have supported the new republic where there will be no discrimination based on race and color. He thanks the international leaders for sharing a common victory for justice, for peace, and for human dignity. What ideas does he set out for the future of South Africa? So, children, here 3 points are to be discussed here. First, Nelson Mandela sets out many ideas for the future of South Africa. First of all, the hated regime of apartheid based on racial discrimination, which will be come to an end for forever. Second, the blacks or any people will not suffer exploitation and oppression by the white people. Third, the new republic will be based on justice, peace and human dignity. There will be equal opportunity for all, irrespective of their race, color and sex. So children, this was the new policy by Mr. Mandela. According to Mr. Mandela, the oppressor must also be be liberated. And a man who takes away another man's freedom is a prisoner of hatred. Now, I am not timely free if I am taking away someone else's freedom. The oppressed and the oppressors alike are robbed of their humanity. So these are some of the famous saying of this, page number 17. And with this, children, the first part of this video ends here. Now I will continue in my next video, the second part of the lesson. With this, I end my video. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.